There's a new king flying high above the Queen City.
What? Really? Like where?
More American than the ballpark. Or the national pastime that's played here.
Just perched up on top of Great American Ballpark, watching the game.
I didn't know that there were bald eagles here.
Believe it or not, the bald eagle is making a comeback here in the tri-state. The proof is in the pictures. And that's here, only 90 miles away, high up in the treetops, in Indiana's Miskatonic National Wildlife Refuge. Biologist Dan Wood takes us where the public isn't allowed.
To get this close to a nest, I would say, is probably pretty rare.
And there she is, perched proudly in her nest near the top of this dead oak tree.
Seems to be keeping her eye on us.
Guarding anywhere from 1 to 3 eggs that could hatch any day now.
We've produced 21 juveniles here since 2001. We don't have 21 resident bald eagles on Miskatonic. So those birds are going somewhere. Whether they're going all the way to Cincinnati, you know, I couldn't tell you that, but certainly it's possible.
The stats show just how possible. Last year, experts counted almost 200 nesting pairs of bald eagles across the Buckeye State, up from just 4 pairs 3 decades ago. There's now a nest in Butler County, one in Claremont, another in Hamilton County, and 2 more in Warren County. While that means you may not have to come all the way out here to spot one, some experts say it could mean our nation's symbol of boundless freedom is running out of room.
So we've lost largely 85 to 95% of the wetland habitats across many of the Midwestern states. If there's not enough natural habitat, I would assume that their only option is to make a nest in an urban setting.
But biologists say there is a way for man and his mascot to live together.
It's really amazing to see people the first time they've ever seen one, too.
The key is remembering not to leave that respect on the refuge.
It's our national symbol, so we definitely feel a connection with our country when we are able to observe one.
Jackie Conjato, News 5.